Hello friends, today let us start chapter number 6 of our science portion. The chapter name is Combustion and Flame. We are going to learn a lot of interesting things in this chapter. Okay. Now let us start by just looking around our home. Okay, we use different kinds of fuels for various purposes in our homes, even in industry, even for running automobiles, etc. Let us name some fuels which we use in our homes, which we use in industry also, and even which we use for running automobiles. Our list, if we make a list, it will contain fuels like cow dung, wood, coal, charcoal, petrol, diesel, CNG, that is compressed natural gas, etc. Now think of it, when we burn a candle and when we burn coal, is there a difference? Have you seen coal being burnt when we go for a Sikh kebab or chicken tikka or even paneer tikka? Whenever a barbecue is done, we do that on a coal stove, right? On a coal, in a coal oven. And a candle, you must have seen a candle burning. Have you seen a difference? The difference you must have seen is that candle burns with a flame. That flame hoti hai, whereas coal does not burn with a flame. Both of them will give out heat, but a candle will also give out light. So if I just write it up here, a candle will give out two things. It will give out heat as well as light, right? Whereas burning of coal will only give heat. It may give a little bit of light, but that is not considered to be anything bright or shiny. Okay, we cannot see in the dark using coal. Very similarly, there are many other materials which will burn but will not give a flame. They'll burn without a flame. So they may burn, they may give out heat, but no light. Let us now study the chemical process of burning and the types of flame which are produced during this process. Let us first define combustion. Okay, in class 7, we had done an activity of burning a magnesium ribbon. This was the experiment. Okay, when you burn a magnesium ribbon, we take a ribbon of magnesium and we give it a little bit of heat, it will start burning and you can see this bright flame or bright light comes, right, with this burning of this magnesium ribbon. So we learned that magnesium burns to form magnesium oxide and it produces heat and light. The equation could be like this: magnesium Mg, that's Mg, plus oxygen O2 would give MgO. So now see, the thing is unbalanced. There are two atoms of oxygen. In this case, there are one oxygen atom of oxygen. So what I'll do is I'll take two atoms of magnesium and I put two atoms of molecules of magnesium oxide. So I'll get this equation: magnesium will burn with oxygen to give out magnesium oxide. It will also give out heat and also give out some light, or in fact in this case a lot of light. We can perform a similar activity with a piece of charcoal. Charcoal is nothing but carbon, carbon plus oxygen would give us carbon dioxide, and it would give out heat, but it will not give out light. So if we bring a piece of charcoal near a flame, we'll see that it burns, right? So charcoal will burn in air, right? With air, it's oxygen in air, right? Same way, coal too will also burn in air, and what will it will do? It will produce carbon dioxide, heat, and a little bit of light, right? Up here, light will be there, but a very little amount of light. So based on this, let us define combustion. A chemical process in which a substance reacts with oxygen to give off heat is called combustion. Let's read it again. A chemical process, see, these are chemical reactions what I'm showing up here. A chemical process in which a substance reacts with oxygen, say magnesium plus oxygen or carbon plus oxygen, to give off heat. Heat is the product which is evolved. Heat is evolved. This process is called combustion. And the substance that undergoes combustion is said to be a combustible substance. It is also called a fuel, right? So what is a fuel? A substance that undergoes combustion is called a fuel. And what is combustion? A chemical process, see, this chemical reaction, right, the process in which any substance reacts with oxygen to give off heat, that is called combustion. Now this fuel, the combustible substance, the fuel, may be either in a solid form like carbon, like coal, it may in a liquid form like petrol, kerosene, etc. It may in gaseous form like CNG, etc. Right? Sometimes light is also given off during combustion. And this light can be either as a flame or as a glow, right? A candle will burn with a flame. When you heat charcoal or coal, it will give a glow. Coal will give a glow. Heat plus a glow, but not a flame. So in the reactions mentioned above, magnesium and charcoal both are combustible substances. Why? Because they will undergo combustion. And what is combustion? Because magnesium and charcoal react with oxygen to give out heat. Now this boy is asking, okay, we were told that food also is a fuel for our body. Now if is food a fuel? So it is true, yes. Why? Because in our body, food is broken down by reaction with oxygen and heat is produced. The reaction is something like this. Food is in the form of glucose. So the glucose is C6H12O6. This is glucose. Glucose and oxygen will react to liberate carbon dioxide plus water vapor plus heat. The whole reaction would be like this. This reaction is an unbalanced reaction. So to balance it out, I'm going to write 6 molecule of carbon dioxide, of oxygen, liberating 6 molecule of carbon dioxide and 6 molecules of water. This is a balanced reaction. You are going to learn about balancing in standard 9th. Okay, now, so food, you can see this process. Food is also a combustion process to some extent, right? But the heat evolved will be very less and very slow. This process is an oxidation process, right, where oxygen is involved. Okay, now let us do one activity and then we stop this video. Collect some materials. We can take straw, matchsticks, kerosene oil, paper, iron nails, stone pieces, glass, etc. Now we try to burn each one of these materials one by one. If combustion takes place, we'll mark them as combustible. Otherwise, if it does not take place, if they don't burn, we'll mark them as non-combustible. Alright, let us take them. Let's take a test up here. So we have these items. Wood. So is wood combustible? Will it burn? Yes, wood will burn. What about paper? Obviously, paper is going to burn. Iron nails will not burn. So iron nails are non-combustible. Kerosene oil is a combustible substance. A piece of stone is a non-combustible substance. Straw is a combustible substance. Charcoal, combustible substance. Matchstick, combustible. And glass, non-combustible substance. You can think of some more items also, right, which are combustible or which are non-combustible. Okay guys, we stop here. We continue activity 6.2 and the topics ahead in the next video. So meet you then. Bye.